Hi there, welcome to another video in the Scriptcase Macros course. My name is Nate Carpenter, and today we're going to look at the scfieldstyle macro. So let's go ahead and see what this macro does. It's very useful, provides a lot of functionality for us, and it allows you to dynamically modify a field's styling. So a lot of the HTML attributes or CSS attributes, actually, you can change very easily with this. So here's the documentation for it. You just pass through the field name, and then that's the only required field. All the others are optional, all the other parameters here. But you can edit these styling attributes. So background color, size, color, it's the font color, the family, the font family, and the weight of that font. And it's on the grid on record event. Let me go ahead and copy this example here and take it over to our grid in Scriptcase development environment. So here I have a grid, and we're going to put this on the on record event. But let's go ahead and run this so you can see what this grid looks like. Okay, so here it is, just a few fields, and we're going to change this active so that when active is 1, it's going to be green. We're going to color that field green, so we're going to go to on record. Let me go ahead and paste in that code. And then we need to change it for that field, so active, that active field there, and then we need to change this color here. So this is just a hex code. You can find the hex code for whatever color you want. We're going to make it green, and we're going to take the font size out and the font color out for now. So these are all optional, so I'm just showing you that. Take the font family out and the font weight out. So just leave those as blank strings. We're just passing through the font color. Let me add one more zero to my hex code to make sure it's correct. And let's go ahead and run this, and we should see a lot of green on this now. So there we go. The active field is green, but the text isn't showing up so well because it's kind of gray. If I highlight it there, you can see it. So let's go ahead and change that font color. So that's going to be the third parameter after the field there, that font color right there. So let's go ahead and change it to black. So that's that third field there, and copy in the hex code for that with the hashtag there, the pound sign. And let me go ahead and run this. And now we should see black text on a green background. So there we go. So that's how you use the scfieldstyle macro to change the various style attributes of a field.